Hello everybody, my name is Jason Block and I'm here with 611connect.com, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Motorola Rival, available on Verizon Wireless for $49.99 in several different colors. So let's take a look at the body of this phone. Now as you can see, it's got a nice little red accent here. You can get the phone also with a little purple accent. But also, as you can see, the phone is pretty ugly. I mean, it's for $50, it's exactly what you paid for, which is a phrase I'm going to be saying a lot in this review. It's kind of lopsided on purpose. It's got this weird little angly pattern here, but on the front it just looks kind of strange. You know, the bevel over here is different than the bevel over here. Now, taking a look at the buttons on the side, you got the very standard array of anything you find on any other cell phone. You got a volume rocker right here, a dedicated speakerphone button, which is pretty nice. You got a USB port. Flipping it over, you got the camera button, you have a voice dialing function, you have the lock button, though you cannot unlock it with this button, you have to use this gigantic button right here to unlock it. And you got a 3.5mm headphone jack, so you can listen to music off of eCast or anything like that. Now looking at the front of the phone, you got the dialer button right here, you got a talk button, an end button, and a back button. Then you got a nice little four-way directional pad and the OK button, which is also what you use to unlock it. Now as you can see, the screen is not the best. It's very suitable for a $50 phone in which most people are just going to be text messaging. You're not going to get any high resolution web pages or look at some high res photos on Flickr. You're going to send text messages. It's also got these little touch sensitive soft keys right here. They're pretty sensitive. I really didn't have to touch it at all. I just had to rub my finger over it and it did what I didn't tell it to do. But also, nice little feature of this phone is that it's a touch screen as well. As you can see, I can dial like so. Though the touchscreen doesn't work on every single menu. As you can see, I go to menu, won't let me select anything. I still have to use the directional pad. Can't do nice little swipes or anything like that. Though the phone does have some nice little animations showing that there is a little bit of power under the hood rather than just an old-fashioned cheapo text messaging cell phone processor. Now, the crown jewel of this phone is its keyboard. The reason why most people are going to buy it. The keyboard is very nice for a phone that's $50. It's pretty close. It's pretty recessed. It doesn't stick out too much, but the keys are pretty easy to differentiate between each other. It's very easy to send out extended messages and whatnot. Though if I did have one problem with this keyboard is that the numbers are arranged on the top rather than in an array such as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So it's absolutely impossible to do any reasonable phone dialing from the keyboard display. You have to go back here and hit that. See, that's the problem, it's too sensitive. Hit that, and then I have to dial in there. A little annoying, but again, you get what you paid for. So, body of this phone is very suitable to its design. It does exactly what it needs to do. It feels sturdy, like most Motorola phones. Doesn't feel like it's gonna break in your hands. Probably give it a few little drops, you know, let it fall out of your pocket a few times, as all teenagers do at some point in their lives. So, for 50 bucks, this is not a horrible investment, body-wise. Now, software-wise, this runs the exact same operating system that you can find on any Razer or Razer 2. There's absolutely nothing new here. For some people, that's fine. For people like me, who are starting to get used to Symbian Series 6 and, you know, Android, it's a little frustrating, but for people who just want to send text messages and make phone calls, it's perfectly fine. As you can see, here's a text messaging screen. It's pretty easy to get around and figure everything out. Everything's colorful and nice and poppy. You know, go to messages, new message, text message, open slider, and I start typing, boop, 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 done. Alright, now let's get out of that. Don't want to save that. Now some other features that this phone has include vCast. Problem is, even just to listen to music, you have to go into the vCast service, which is pretty ugly, as you can see. It pops and the interface works, but it's definitely uglier than any other music interface on any other phone out there. So let's check out the music playing app. You can see here some Black Eyed Peas. I'm going to play Boom Boom Pow. A little tiny music display right here. You got album art. Speaker is right here in the back. As you can hear, it's fine. You're probably not listening to this with headphones anyway, unless you're showing your friends a song or something like that. Absolutely nothing special. You can save quite a bit of contacts, up to 1,000, with 5 phone numbers apiece, which is pretty nice, especially for the popular kids in school, you know, with all their texting buddies. So yes, the software does exactly what you need it to do. So, battery life. I may not be as avid as a texter as a lot of high schoolers out there, so I was able to get about two days of use out of it, sparingly playing music and going on the internet and such, but I'm guessing that most people are going to end up charging this phone once a day. Also, call quality-wise, I was able to get good reception nearly everywhere, and people I talked to said that I sounded just as normal as I would on any cell phone. They didn't notice that it was a different phone and not my current Nokia. So yes, call quality and battery life, all solid. In conclusion, this is one of the better text messaging phones that I have ever tested, Verizon or any other carrier. Most of the time, manufacturers and carriers decide to put cheaper and less effective processors and pieces of software on these little phones in an attempt to push them out at prices about $20 and $30. This phone does not do that. For $50, you get a phone that has a very capable processor, a pretty average screen, even including a touch screen, and very quick operation all around. It also has a very solid build and a lot of really tactile buttons to make up for very annoying ones that aren't very tactile. So I highly recommend this phone. The Motorola Rival costs $50 at Verizon Wireless right now, no rebates. I highly recommend it. This is Jason Block for 611 Connect, signing off.